Just a short, quick khatira to keep us warm in this beautiful weather. Ahl al-Suffa. Ahl al-Suffa, the people of Suffa, are companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that were very poor, and they used to live in the back of the masjid. And the Sahaba used to come, every time they come, they brought them food, they take care of them. But they were very well known. At times they're 9, 10, sometimes 20, 30. They vary every once in a while. One of these people, his name is Rabi'a bin Ka'b al-Aslami. Rabi'a al-Aslami. Rabi'a is narrating a hadith, and the hadith is in Sahih Muslim. Most of you know the hadith, but there's a lesson I want to derive from this hadith. So Rabi'a said, I used to serve Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and I used to stay by his door in case he got up in the middle of the night and he wants wudu, I have the water ready for him. So one time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam came out and he saw me waiting for him with the wudu. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he told me, Salni ya Rabi'a. Rabi'a got the gift that every single Muslim dream about, which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam telling you, what do you want? What do you want? Ya Rabi'a, ask me, what do you want? Before I continue, I was thinking, if I am that poor and I'm living in the back of the masjid, and the man himself, the best man ever walked this earth, ask me, what do you want? I was telling myself, and I want you to do the same. I said to myself, Ya Rasulullah, just a room for some privacy, maybe a couple of goats to milk them, maybe a camel I can use as an Uber, take people, you know, back and forth, use it as for transportation. This is what I would think about, you know, just, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asking me, and then, you know, the rest of the stuff, I would work very hard to get to Jannah. I'm from the people of the Masjid Nabawi. No, this is not Rabi'a, this is Bajur. Rabi'a is a different category, different level. Said, Ya Rasulullah, I want your company in Jannah. In one narration, it says, Ya Rasulullah, who knows the narration? Give me till tomorrow. You know, keep in mind, we're talking about some narration said 11, some 12. The highest I saw was 17 years old. 11 to 17, yani this is the age of Rabi'a at that time. I want your company in Jannah. Look at the high ambition, the high aspiration. He does not want Jannah. He wants the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because he knows that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a different level. And I want to be your neighbor. I want to be with you, Ya Rasulullah, in Jannah. Now, wallahi, this is nothing compared to what happened after. And that's what drove me crazy. So after he told him, Ya Rabi'a, what do you want? Rabi'a said, I want your company in Jannah. And this is here where it blows your mind. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, listen carefully, أَغَيْرَ ذَلِكَ. Let's go back to Bajur. Anything else? طيب, I asked for the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah. I asked Rasulullah, a small room, privacy, a goat I can milk, a camel I can use for transportation. Right? I got the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first one, I asked for the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is great, unbelievable, amazing for such an age to ask such a request. Anything else, Ya Rabi'a? What did Rabi'a say? Nothing. Nothing, Ya Rasulullah. This is it. That's all I want. That's all I want. You know, with your son, come. Come one second. He's shy. Your son, come. That young boy right there. Yeah. Come over here. Come. Ah, this guy came. Okay. All right, it's okay. You can come, both of you. I want to just tell you an example of what Rabia is doing. Okay, habibi. What do you want, lollipop or $20? This is the difference between Rabia and Bajur. Here's $20 for you. Okay, you're looking at it. Okay. This is exactly what's happening. Rabia did not pick the lollipop. We are picking the lollipop. Rabia picked the 20. Because he does not want instant gratification. And this is what Allah told us in the Quran. Tuhibbuna al-ajila. You love instant gratification. You want to be rewarded now. Now. Rabia, no, no. It's okay. I will live in the Masjid al-Nawawi. I will stay in the back for a while. How long am I going to live? 20, 30, 50, 60 years? This is nothing compared to the Akhirah. This is nothing compared to the Akhirah. So, Rabia, very high ambition. Now, what is the prescription? Because it's not only for Rabia, so it's for everybody. What is the prescription to get the company of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in Jannah? May Allah grant us this. Ameen, Ya Rabbi Alameen. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam gave it to him and to the whole ummah. Ya Rabia, a'inni ala nafsika bikathratis sujood. Listen, we all know this statement, very, very famous statement. But I want you to dissect it today. A'inni ala nafsika. You know how we say here in America, help me, help you? Help me, help you. He said, a'inni ala nafsika bikathratis sujood. Help me ala nafsika. Against your desire. The desire, the nafs, ammara bisu, in general, the nafs always orders evil. So ya Rabi'a, help me by fighting your desire. How? Bi kathrat sujood. Do a lot of sujood. Here, a lot of sujood does not mean I'm standing like this and I said I make sajda. Here, kathrat sujood means a kathrat salat. Pray a lot. Do a lot of prayer. And obviously, that does not mean Fajr, Dhuhr, and Asr, because this is a given, right? It means a lot of optional, a lot of sunnahs. Ya Rabi'a, you want my company? Help me. Now listen here. He did not tell him, you got it. What does that mean? Ya Akhwan, when you make dua, you gotta do something. Rabi'a, I can give you that. I can ask Allah for that. But you have to do something. Do something. We make dua and sometimes we go to sleep. أَعِنِّي عَلَى نَفْسِكَ بِكَثْرَةِ السُّجُودِ. Get up. Pray tahajjud. Make a lot of sujood. Pray the duha. Pray the sunan of the salawat. Make sure you pray a lot. كَثْرَةِ السُّجُودِ. Now, why sujood? Sujood is, subhanAllah, like one of our shuyukh, he said one time, shuyukh, salat, sujood is so beautiful that everything is once except sujood is twice. Sujood, you are whispering on the earth and your statement is echoing in the heavens. Sujood, you are the closest to Allah Azza wa Jal, according to the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and there's an ayah in the Quran that tells me that the closest I am to Allah when I am in sujood. Which ayah is that? Fasjud waqtarib. Fasjud waqtarib. Make sujood and come closer to me. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, you want to be in my company? Do a lot of sujood. Be close to Allah. Because sujood, you're the closest to Allah. Be as close as possible to Allah. And what else is sujood? Sujood, ya akhwan, if you're going through any kind of stress, depression, anxiety, all kinds of hardships, Allah Azza wa Jal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the last ayat in Surah Al-Hijr. وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ يَضِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ. Listen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calming Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rasulullah, I know, Allah is saying, I know that your heart is distressed of what they're saying about you. the names they're calling you, Majnoon, Sha'ir, Sahir, you know, magician, crazy. Huh? They're calling all these names, and I know that you don't like it. What should I do, Ya Allah? فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ. Number one, say a lot of tasbih. Subhanallah wa bihamdi. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Allah is telling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we know what's going on in your heart. How could we resolve it? فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَكُمْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ. The second, make a lot of sujood. وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. You want, you're stressed, you're going through hardships. Say a lot of subhanallah, subhanallah wa bihamdih. Make a lot of sujood. استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة. Go pray two rak'ah. And ask Allah to relieve that stress. And continue to worship Allah until the death comes. وَعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ. And worship your Lord. Not until Ramadan is over. حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Yaqeen here, even though we all know that yaqeen means certainty. And is there anything more certain than death? Worship your Lord until death comes to you. مجاهد من جاهد نفسه في طاعة الله. Every single one of us want to be a mujahid, especially when they hear what's happening in Gaza. May Allah bless us with shahada in his cause. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the daily mujahid is the one who performs jihad against his desire. Okay, I'm going to make you practice this, inshallah ta'ala, this jihad tomorrow at Fajr. I want you all to come here at Fajr, make jihad against that blanket, make jihad against sleeping, and I'll see you tomorrow, inshallah ta'ala, at 6:30 to pray Fajr. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya عليه وسلموا تسليما. إن الذين يؤذون الله ورسوله لعنهم الله في الدنيا والآخرة وأعد لهم عذابا مهينا. والذين يؤذون المؤمنين والمؤمنات بغير ما اكتسبوا فقد احتملوا بهتانا وإثما مبينا.